Hello everyone, welcome back to HPI Guys Model Workshop. We're going to be building up AMT's 125th scale Super Boss Funny Car Chevy II. It's got a 427 fuel injected engine under the hood, got this sweet Chevy II body. There's only one way to build this, and that is as a dragster. So let's take a look at everything in the box when you snag yours. First up will be the tire tree. Yes, this has styrene tires. They look absolutely fine, as you've seen me do them in other kits. So you'll see, we'll get some paint on those. They're gonna look nice behind the wheels. We've got our roll cage parts here, our racing seat, and that does have belts molded in it. We've got our steering wheel, and it's even got little holes molded we can blackwash inside there. Nice thick roll bar with attachment points and little nipples on there. We got the nice hood cutout for the fuel injection. That's pretty awesome on the bottom side. Got the stock hood latch, got the stock look to it, so that's pretty awesome. Like a, not a purpose-built funny car, but a modified one. Check out that body. Nice crisp molding, got the altered wheelbase on it. Got the nice trim work. Still left the windshield wipers on it in case they drag in the rain. This one does have the fenders attached. Go all the way around, we've got our back panel and inserts for our taillights, must be on the other parts. Door handles, door seams all look good. Don't see anything crushed, don't see any flash that needs to be worried about, and everything is nice and crisp on that body. The interior is completely smooth. Obviously, this has been altered with the huge tubbed out back end. So we can do that in a metallic color if we want. We could paint some of that, but I highly doubt there would be any carpet or anything in a funny car. Could you imagine having carpet in it when you got into a wreck and some fuel get in there? Whew, that is a fireball. We've got our engine and transmission for the 427 all as one. We got some trailing arms here, or our track bars here. We got our radiator mount. We got another free seat for you in there if you want to put two seats in. There are only grooves for one. So if you want to add a second seat, you can go right ahead. Otherwise, you can leave it. We got our dashboard here with very large prominent gauges on that funny car dashboard. I'm going to be able to show you in this video how to detail those without having any decals needed. We got our nice parachute. We got fuel injection parts. We got a starter, distributor, and cylinder heads all on that tree. I'm not seeing any flash we need to worry about. I'm not seeing any warpage. It all looks flat to me. Once we bring it down, we got our tubbed out rear end and frame. We got our regular, we got our modified chassis here for the funny car. Nice large piece of, I love the sound of styrene, don't you? I know that makes you guys so nervous. He's gonna break it. We got our differential and springs in the back, which helps us align everything. We got a two-piece on there. We've got, this is the header collector, is what that is, in case you're wondering. We got our multi-piece header and dumps all in one. She got dumps like a truck. Remember that song? Wow. Song's like 25 years old if you want to feel old right now. So you can see all those will go together. They got little grooves on this side and no grooves on this side, so we should be able to clamp them and glue them together. We're going to switch to the other side of the table. We've got a large one-piece windshield and back glass, which look just fine when they're installed and allow you to install it quite nicely with the cutout there. We've got a sweet improved decal sheet, 427, that says cubic inch after it in white. These say bad news if you can't pick them up on camera. We got the AXS emblems. We got Goodyear emblems. Bad news travels fast is what that says on there. We got all kinds of contingency. We got some cute this end up. It'd be on a neat on an off-road truck diorama. We got Autoworld model logos. We got some nice hood striping if you want to do it like the box art. And I'm really digging that bumblebee look on the box art with the Twister logos in purple. We got big Chevy logos, number callouts, 65. Great big decal sheet to use on multiple vehicles. And we've got our chrome tree. We've got some inner wheels. We've got timing covers. We've got our Hillborn intake. Beautiful set of wheels. grill, we can black wash all inside of here. You'll watch that come out in the video. We got our tail lights here. We've got oil pan, valve covers, you can leave them chrome. Careful with this chrome tree, check the bag. Numerous injectors are off the tree and floating loose in the bag, so just keep an eye on them. I had three floating around and the rest are attached in various points on the tree, but they get pushed over in the box. We got our moon fuel tank, we got some leaf springs for the front end, we got our front axle there, we got our steering rod. Nice chrome tree on there, and then we're going to have our standard exploded AMT manual, which lets you put things together quite easily. Should be a very easy assembly process, which is what I'm going to get to right now.
Thank you.
going over the parts on this one. Very easy, just as the assembly process on this one is super duper easy. Let's go over what we've got going on. We've got that 427 assembled. I did attach the starter and the cylinder heads, but that's it. The rest, the oil pan, the valve covers, the intake, the timing color, I want to leave in the chrome. I like how it looks on there, so that goes together quite fine. We will do some hand painting on that after we get our main color on it. The tire package, the nice Goodyear tires go together just fine. You can see, and once we get some spray paint on them, they're going to look every bit the part underneath the car. We've built these plastic tires in other kits before, other versions and these versions, and they always come out just fine. You're gonna see that. I know there's a lot of nailing, wailing, and gnashing of teeth about styrene tires, but they're not bad at all. They're not bad. The only thing they don't have that I wish they had with plastic tires was, I wish they had tire decals that we could stick on those, because then they would look, if you didn't tell someone they were plastic, they probably would never know. We got the differential and spring system set up in the back. I'll show you how easy that's going to go into the car in a second. The hood, we've got, I'll just leave it on its tree and touch up any paint I need to when I'm done painting. We've got our distributor, an extra seat, our radiator surround, our track bars, our dashboard, and our intake parts for the fuel injectors. Those are all set up here, so we'll get those primed together, we'll get them painted, and we'll be set with those. The headers went together far easier than I thought they would. They line up very nicely. We got our collector on the bottom there. You saw how they went together in the assembly portion, so we don't need to discuss that a lot in these videos anymore, but you could see that they look just fine, and they're gonna glue on when we're all done. I can get those painted on their own. Differential over there. These parts of the chrome tree, you can see I've separated it from the wheels, the bumper, and the grill, stuff like that. The reason being is I don't want these to look chrome. I want these to look raw metal. So I will show you how I do that in the painting section. We got an easy way to do that. On this part here, we've got our drive shaft, seat, steering wheel, and wheel backs, and our parachute. I all want those to be the same color, and then I'll detail them from there. So I'm leaving those on their little tree stubs. We've got the chassis here. You saw me use the interior to line up these front support bars on the chassis. Now that is completely separate. Once we lift that up, those are glued into place, and we know they're lined up, and I can paint that with the chassis. I've also got the front suspension and axle glued in place because I don't want those chrome. So I super glued those in, and now I can paint those with the chassis. I wanted to show you how easy that differential will drop in when we're all done. Like so. That's it. Lines up nicely. We'll be able to set that up and work on it. And then our interior, we see we've got the interior tub. You saw how I can get that roll bar ready. I just put it in place. I glue together the ends with my favorite model glue. And then we are set to go. That is a separate piece. And our body is ready for paint. That is it. That's as easy as this is. Very easy assembly, very quick assembly, like 45 minutes into that. I'm going to throw some paint on it right now. Well, normally I put decals on after I get the body on and have pretty much the entire car done. This one, because this body shows to me that it goes on very easily, it just literally plops over the top, I decided to do the decals in part of the detail video and not do decals later, do it all in one and let you see it. So now we can see what's left before we button everything up. The final parts to be glued on will be the stacks on the intake, and we'll wait till the car's all together and the body's on so I can line those up and get those glued in place. I'll use a little bit of super glue to stick those on. We got the hood that will just drop right onto the body. That fits lovely. As I say that, of course, it's so far away from me. There we go. You can see that fits on without a problem. I went with a black glossy hood on mine and then the yellow with the black stripes. It's your model. You build it however you want. The decals are there if you wanted to stripe your hood or if you want to leave it primer or whatever you decide. The body just kind of falls right over the chassis. It's that easy to do. So we'll take a look at the chassis. We got the 427 under the hood. We got all the different colors on the engine. I've got the headers glued on with their dumps in the nice white. We've got that interior, very basic, I mean, but it is a dragster. It's not streetable whatsoever. I showed you how to do those gauges without decals. Got our shifter in, got our seat belts. Underneath, extremely basic. You can see the different tones underneath that'll bring things out, and I used a black Sharpie at the end of the headers so that it looks black on there. Everything on the body, shake the hood off, goes together nicely. The front and rear bumper are just held on with friction. They just press in. Got the parachute on, got the tail lights glued in place. They just drop into place. You could attach them with Mod Podge, super glue, whatever you want. Same with the glass, just goes in very easy on the inside of the body. The decals laid on nicely. I did all the trim work on it, even though a funny car probably wouldn't have a lot of trim. Did our vents, did our windshield, and did our grill and turn signals. And that just presses in. It's got these long pins that presses in to get the grill in, and that holds your front fenders together. So that is it. Got our wheel and tire package done. Those look sharp. All set, ready to go, ready to be placed underneath the car. So I'm gonna press those wheels on the front wheels. I did drill them out a little bit. It is a very tight fit onto these axles, and as fragile as that front axle is attached on those little springs, I didn't wanna break anything off. On the rear wheels have these large pins, and they just kind of screw themselves in there and you'll be set on the rear axle. But the front was a little fragile, so I didn't want to mess that up. We are all set to go. I'll press it together, and then we'll be back for the final. And with the last couple steps of final assembly, all those stacks glued on, those are nice large attachment points, and it's not a butt joint, it is an actual A to B. They've got a peg on the intake, and then the stack just sticks right over the top of it, so I put a little thick super glue on there and stuck it right over, lined them up as best I could, and then I put a little drop of black wash in the top of each one so it looks like it's got the big rabbit hole there. So we are all set. I mean, that body just sits right down on the chassis like you saw. The decals go down very, very nicely. Not a drop of decal solvent as you saw, just warm soapy water, laid them on, and they conformed very well. The entire kit, if you need a brake and you want to build a dragster, but you just built something pretty complicated, just like the Greyhound bus I just did before this video, here's something for you. This is a slump breaker. It's easy to build. If you've been stressed out with some other builds, you can slap this thing together and paint it up any way you want. Put those nice decals on it. You're not gonna have to fight with little tiny mirrors on the side or bumpers or lights that don't wanna go in or finicky glass. This kit just goes together easily. You don't even have to sand the tires because they are styrene. Beautiful headers on there. We did have the longer form headers as well if you wanted to run them further back in the car. It did have those in the box. And of course, you got an extra seat and a couple extra parts in here. And then you've got a Brazilian extra decals on there. I really enjoyed this kit. I'm glad Round 2 sent this over. I will link down in the description so that when this is out and available, if it's not out by the time this build video comes out, you can snag your own. As always, thanks for watching the workshop. I always enjoy building up these old school reissue kits. It's just nostalgia, good times, and they're always real simple. They always just kind of slap together, and you can build a nice looking car for the shelf with them. Always build your model cars for you. Have a good time, smile, realize it's just a hobby, and we'll see all of you at the next review.